Praise the Lord and God bless you and thank you for tuning in to the program Anointing. I'm Apostle Vincent Akosa of Christ Citadel International Church, one church in four places here in California. I know that I've been absent from the screen for a while. I've been traveling, you know, a bit. But thank God that my journey has come to an end and I'm back to the studio for us to continue from where we left off. Our last program, God bless us and grace us with a very important individual, important in the kingdom of God. Everybody is important, of course, but there are certain individuals who are living the vision by the grace that God has given unto them. And it is very, very important that we recognize such individuals, not to just, you know, promote them in any way, but to also, because they are inspirational figures, that what they stand for, the vision and the guidance and the conviction and their faith can also rub on people to inspire others. Today, I'm truly, truly blessed to have in the studio a man who needs no introduction because he is the visionary behind this network that is being a blessing all over the world. This is, you know, this program is reaching in the excess of 100 million people across the globe. And this is one man's vision that is making it possible. And you are there, some people's lives are being touched, people are being saved, healing miracles are happening. And sometimes you also need to hear from the person that God laid the burden of the vision, who, you know, in obedience to and guidance of the Holy Spirit enabled this to be possible. So we thank God, we join the family in the way in the Cross TV in celebrating the 5th anniversary, which was last Saturday, and it's 5th anniversary of this network. And I want to welcome the CEO and the president and the visionary behind the way and the Cross TV, Dr. Joseph Nasrallah.
Apostle Vincent Akosa, every time I'm here with you in the program, I feel the presence of God, and I feel really, really that you have the passion for the TV ministry, aside with all the churches that you are shepherd. And definitely I need just to, I know it's something personal, but I need to dedicate this episode today for the life of the mother-in-law of you, that she went to the heaven to be with the angels, with God. And I'm really sending my regards and my prayer for your precious wife. And I know that you have been traveling to do this, but I dedicate this because we believe in life, not in the death. But the Lord gonna give us a very strong episode today, and I'm dedicated to your mother-in-law.
Thank you so much for your concern. I deeply appreciate it. Well, I know that the other day you did articulate, but time was much of a constraint, so you couldn't give us significant highlights as to what inspired you to get this network started. You are not a Native American. You came from elsewhere. You and I, we share the same kind of vision. You know, we just emigrated here and then started the ministry as we felt led by the Lord. You know, but when you even came here, you were not even an ordained minister. Mm. You were a musician. Mm. And then, so can you give us some of the scenarios, how you got started?
Amen. When I came here, I came as a singer, as you know, and I'm composing a lot of songs, a lot of worship and praise songs. The Lord gave me, by the grace of God, until today, it's about 104 songs.
It's
lyrics and the melody. I bought it, and I was celebrating my 100 songs like 2 months ago, and then the Lord is giving more and more, I know. I came as a singer, as some churches invited me in the United States because I have been producing 4 albums in Egypt before I come here, after my testimony, after I came to Jesus Christ, as you know, from the casinos and from the nightclubs, comes singing in the secular world, and then the Lord brought me with to be honored to serve the Lord in the music and the worship. And I produced 4 albums. At that time, pastors keep inviting me in the Arabic churches here. And I came here 2000, 2002, and then 2003, the Lord put the vision on my heart to just, this is going to be the land that you're going to set up the rockets all over the world. It's through the ministry, the spiritual vision that the Lord gave it to me. I didn't know it's related to the one that I got it in the pit. When I was there, I was seeing myself singing in front of unlimited people. The stadium is, you cannot count the end of the people sitting in the stadium. I didn't know. I was in the pit. I was in the very miserable case, but the Lord gave me the vision. I didn't know it's a TV station, that when I talk right now in front of the camera, no stadium will content the people is watching you right now in the episode. So that's how I started the vision here. I said, okay, Lord, you know, America is the land of the dreams, but you are the one who bought the dreams. So if this is the land of the dreams, let me start it here. And then I share with my wife. I have been away from her for about 1 year here alone, set up everything, finishing the paperwork for immigration, empty-handed, doesn't have anything, just walk on the water with faith to bring my family. At that time, I was having Giovanni. He's 3 years old, and my wife. And then I left them for about 1.5 years until they came here. And then when they came, we established the TV here. It was starting with a very small camera, but I have the heart to broadcast whatever the camera is captured to all over the world. And then, you know, whenever you put something in front, in God's hand, 5 loaves and 2 fishes is going to be multiplied. as you also witness that, and you have been living like this, you come empty hand, and then you see the Lord is putting more and more in your hand.
Praise God. But the thing is, there's a story behind the story.
Yes.
And you kind of oversimplify it because you yourself, you have a personal testimony. Mm-hmm. You know, before you got born again, I think you have given a certain, you know, snippets of it. Mm-hmm. But the persecution that you endured, mm-hmm. you know, the torture. You know, sometimes when people see you, they see you as, you know, like you are sitting down here mm-hmm. in tie, comfortable, and people don't know your story. Mm. You know, like the message that was preached some time ago about, you know, somebody say, show your scars. Mm. You have scars to show, evidence of persecution and your stubborn resistance mm. to those who wanted you to give up your faith. Can you just share a little to inspire the TV audience, if
sure.
it's possible?
Yeah. Sure, Apostle Akosa. It's my life story. And then I'm really honored that the Lord is putting my life to go through those things. Even, you know, it's challenges, and there is a lot of persecution in my country, my beloved country, Egypt, which I love so much. And I have been away from my country a long time because of the persecution. And you feel like if somebody insulates you from Ghana, you will feel like, oh my God, I need to go to my country. This is my prayer. One day the Lord gonna send me back to Egypt. But at that moment, Christians doesn't have any rights in Egypt. And still until now, we are trying to fight for our rights to be living there as a people, as not second class people, but the Lord is creating us as a human, so we should live, and we have freedom of religion. But in the Muslim countries, no freedom of religion. It calls freedom of religion. You can just choose your, they allow you to practice your religion, but very tight, very, they're putting a lot of pressures there. So I was trying to escape, as I told you, since I was born as a Christian in the Christian family, I was telling myself, let me escape. Let me escape on the nightclubs. Let me escape on the music industry. Let me escape by doing songs, secular songs, dancing, belly dancers, and stuff like this, so I can hide from that. I didn't know that while I'm hiding, I'm doing like exactly like Jonah, what the Lord is calling Jonah to do something, and then I'm hiding. And then the visions, and there is dreams that the Lord gonna use me, and then I'm trying to push him away. Even the person who was witnessing to me, trying to bring me to Jesus Christ, he said, please come. I 7 days I'm rejecting him in the door of the nightclub, saying to him, no, I'm not going with you. I don't need your Jesus. And then one day I was like just saying to let me go, because he's insisting, he's coming every night, he's doing that, let me get rid of him. So that I didn't know that's my salvation day. When I went to him, the Holy Spirit captured my heart, and then I got saved. It's a long story, but I'm answering the question that there is a story after a story, or the story behind the story, that the persecution allowed me to be in jail for the things that I don't know, I don't do, I never did wrong. But the only thing I did is I distribute the Bible in my army base. At that time, they captured me and they put me in jail, and then start the persecution trip for about 4 months, daily persecution. One night, the knife was here, then trying to kill me, or I have to do the other religion thing, or become Muslim. But I said, no, I will never deny Jesus Christ. And then at that time, the Lord gave me wisdom to tell them, ask them questions, start with questions. And there is a long format for my testimony, but to make the story short, I have been tortured in this pit. I always feel the glory of God, even in the middle of the torture. So that's how make the muscles right now. Sometimes the circumstances make you have a spiritual muscles to face other things that the Lord gonna you're gonna go through with the Lord. But always I feel him, he's carrying me. Always, like if you see that the scars and those things, the pain, it should be very painful. It should be very painful, but the Lord did that with me. And he wave away all these painful things that I have.
Praise God. God bless you. I mean, this is, you know, people sometimes, God, they see you in front of camera and they don't know the story. Mm. How, you know, and we need to tell our stories along to inspire and to encourage others.
Yes.
You know, and thank you for, you know, I know it's very personal, but you've been able to open up to inspire so many people. One thing about you is that you are a man who wears several hats for the kingdom. Mm. I mean, you run this network, which can keep you 24/7. You also do the music, the praise and worship, which is your passion. And you also do missions. Mm. You do missionary work and things like that. You know, God bless us with an opportunity to travel once to London, and there are many more that we expect to do together. And I thank God for the great anointing that is on you. And we are very, very humble about it. But I know that you have a passion. And I know that sometimes, you know, the last time that we met, a lot of water has passed under the bridge. You know, now, you know, our country, the president has declared Jerusalem as, you know, is moving the U.S. embassy from Tel Aviv to Jerusalem. And we are not politicians, we are Christians. Mm. The politics aside, what happened with the Balfour Treaty and all those things, you know, we are Christians. And we know that one day the Christ will come.
Yes.
And, you know, he will be establishing the eternal kingdom, eternal city, Jerusalem, will be the capital of the world. Mm. Many Christians are euphoric because they see it as part of, you know, the eschatological development of we are in the time that we are in, because for them it points to the coming of the Christ and all that. But we are not looking into that, you know. What we are driving at is this, you know, that you have a passion for Jerusalem and also leading Christians. And what do you have to say for those who don't have the benefit of ever being there? You and I have been there before.
Yes.
And I told you that as soon as I arrived in Jerusalem, it's like my Bible was before me, now in real geographic depiction, you know. So it made certain things more meaningful and more understandable to me. What do you have to say to people who are yearning to go there? And sometimes some are also afraid of the security situation, so you just come. What do you say to such individuals?
I can tell you that if you ask anybody went there or go to Jerusalem or the Holy Land, Israel, Beit Lahem, if you ask what is the most incredible thing that you what is your dream, he's gonna say that I like to share what I have experienced so everybody in the all entire world go visit what's going on there, which is this is the plan that the Lord is giving you for the church, which is I love so much because you went there and you saw by your eyes, you was diving in the Bible anyway, like you whenever that's the only term I can say, you can dive in the Bible and just see the things in the Bible like in front of your eyes. Here is the Tiberia Lake that when Jesus was walking on the water and then Peter came and walked in the water. Oh my God, he was there, yes, here. And then you see the mountain when he feed everybody there, when he had the 5 loaves and two fishes. And this is the mountain that everybody was sitting there. You cannot imagine, this is the mountain. And then you go to the tomb and go to the empty place that Jesus is not there. He raised from the dead, and here was laying here. His body was laying here. Is this the place that, it's not about the place, it's about the presence of God, that the mighty Father, when he is in the picture of the man, he was here. And you feel like the plan of God is so accurate. And this is the proof that he went to the cross, because other religions say that he never went to the cross. And this is the proof that he resurrected from the dead. And he born here from Virgin Mary, and she was laying him here, and she was having him, taking care of him in this place, and this place. And you feel like you are walking in these places? Oh my God. When I went there the first time, two more months, I said, when they invite me back, I said, okay, I'm coming to sing. So any invitation from the Holy Land, I'm accepting right away because I know that I'm going to see more adventure, more things that, but I know that the trip that the Lord is putting in your heart and your church is organized and your church is organized, it's going to be, I think, 10 days. It's going to cover everything. It's going to cover the whole entire Holy Land, so the people will never miss anything. I think it's going to be a great, great, great trip.
Thank you. I think it is to give people a practical feel of what the Bible has said, you know, about the Holy Land, because actually, you know, it falls into the dynamic of the promise of God for his people, you know, and we do this to encourage people, those who have the means. It doesn't mean that if you don't go there, you are not going to heaven or anything.
I know.
You know, but for you to be able, it actually reinforces certain convictions and open your eyes to certain essential dynamics within the gospel, so that the strength of your faith is even more reinforced because of your, you know, the meaningful understanding that you get by the practical exposure to everything that the Bible says. When you go and you have a feel like you're talking about, you know, the Tiberias River and all those kind of things. I want you also to give us, because since you mentioned it, give us a perspective of the spiritual component, because I know people of different spiritual persuasions do their pilgrimage. We are not going on a pilgrimage, so to speak. You know, what do you think is the spiritual benefit for
spiritual benefit? First of all, you have been reading the Bible. The Bible said that the faith is something that you believe in without your eyes. Okay. But there is a lot of people like Thomas. They need to have this physical thing to see.
To touch, yes.
But in the Holy Land, it's a different story. I'm not going there so I can touch. Even if I live my life here, I'll never go. I know that Jesus has been resurrected from the dead, so he went to the cross. But for you to prove to others that not believing that, oh, I saw that it was my apple eyes there. So spiritually, you're going to transfer to other levels. Second, you feel the presence of God. The presence of God is here, yes, and here, and here, and here. But there is another experience to have sometimes a heavy presence of God, a very anointed, heavy presence of God. You can touch it. You can feel it. I think you felt it there.
Absolutely.
So that's why I'm inviting and I'm encouraging and I'm saying to everybody, come to this trip. It's not because of this trip particularly, but you know what? This trip is going to be different because, first of all, we have Apostle Akosa with us. Because he is a very humble person, he can explain every single thing on those places. Plus, the tour guide, he's going to explain also historically what's going on. And we have First Lady with us as well. We have a very good group. By the way, I need to surprise you on air. There is a lot of other people here on the Cross TV from the programs. They are watching and they said, you know what? We're going to join Apostle Akosa trip. And they
thank
need
you.
To register right away.
All right. Thank you.
Man,
thank
so you. So I'm so exciting. I'm so exciting for this trip.
Thank you. And you're also coming along.
So. Yes, yes, yes.
Anyway, so... brothers and sisters in the audience, we want to encourage you that if you can join us, the trip is on the 9th of June, but please, we want you to call the studio as early as possible so that you can make your reservations. We don't have an airplane sitting down there waiting for us to take our sweet time and then get ready, but we have to make sure that we make our reservations way ahead so that they can give us, you know, reserve so much seats for us so that we can all go together and see things for ourselves, the evidence, as Dr. Joseph was pointing, that the Christ indeed came, died, and rose again. That encapsulates the whole gospel, the birth of the Christ, the death of the Christ, and the resurrection of the Christ, and the anticipated soon coming of our King of Kings and Lord of Lords. Want to thank you for joining us, but before we wind up, I want you, Dr. Joseph, to say a prayer to Amen. Bless the people.
Amen. Thank you, Lord, for this episode. Thank you, Lord, for this show. Thank you, Lord, for the glory of God over Apostle Akosa, Lord, and the churches that he is shepherd. Lord, bless him, bless his wife, Lord. Bless every viewer right now. Thank you, Lord, for the people who are joining us. Lord, we know that the reality is you came to the earth all the way from the heaven just for our salvation. Lord, touch the hearts right now to get the salvation, to get the salvation to know Jesus Christ. Lord, we thank you for the word of God from Apostle Akosa. Thank you for the living word. Thank you, Lord, for the living water. Thank you, Lord, for the living life that you are giving us as a gift. In Jesus' name, I'm praying to bless every viewer and to bless this show and this program all the time. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen. Thank you so much, Dr.
Thank
Joseph.
Thank
and happy
Apostle.
Anniversary
thank
for
you.
The great. We expect that God thank will expand and enlarge your coast. And all of you, thank you so much for joining us. Till next week, I'm Apostle Vincent Akosa of Christ Central International Church, and thank you for joining us for the anointing. Be blessed.